What's up, peeps? How are you guys doing? And look at this big monstrous boat, which was one of the biggest aircraft at its time. You got the Latécoère 631. And we are right now in we're going to CTL. Right now we are in Iraklion. We'll be taking off from I forgot the name of it. I think it was Nia Ali Karnassos. We're pretty close. Well, I guess not really close, but we're Athens, is that? Greece, pretty much. That's how far from Greece we are. We are in the Sea of Crete. We're just doing a short flight right here to land around the water of Scythia, close to it. LGST. Anyway, so let's get started. We got the tugboat. Comes with a tugboat, guys, by Blue Mesh. I think it is an amazing looking boat. I mean, not looking boat, look at me. Looking aircraft at this time, I think it was 1942, if I'm not mistaken. Let's go ahead and get her started up. I'm not going to go through the whole checklist, because it's just too much for a video, short video, you know? So we're going to tell the tugboat to turn left here. Yeah. Beautiful, isn't it? It's full speed too. So you can control the tugboat right here. Got the undercarriage when you're on the ground. You got electrical generators and stuff you can turn on. What we're going to be doing today is we are in cold and dark, but we're not going to do the checklist. It has a bunch of... Sorry for the blur there. And then auto start is what we're going to be doing today. Okay. So do not worry, it's not going to be a lengthy checklist. We're going to be going towards the east. And then we'll take off from there. It is windy. That's something I did notice, I think. It's around, the wind is 310 at 24 knots. And the real world weather is 310 at 19 knots, which is still pretty close. A few numbers off, but... Alright, let's make sure we get this correct here. Alright, I think that's good. Make sure you guys like and subscribe for more videos, because this is looking beautiful. Alright, we'll tell the tugboat to slow us down here. Alright, man, you can slow us down. Thank you so much for your assistance. Tugboat is removed. We'll start the auto start process, which is gonna do everything for us. You got a hide additional flag. Brings out the France flag, of course. High dock, which comes with the dock. Anchor buoy. Has the anchor buoy in the front there, and then the engine covers. But okay. Auto start. Gives us everything we need to know. It is beautifully detailed. I would imagine how much time he took to get everything done correctly. We might take a look at that while... This is starting up. Let me see if we can tow. Can we still tow while... No, we cannot. Alright, sorry about that. Not too sure why it was turning our vehicle, our aircraft. So did I get all of them on? It looks like all of them are on. So we'll start moving in a bit here. So it's just pretty much flying right straight over, over the land here. Then we're gonna just land this around here, maybe. What's the secret? Make sure you guys like and subscribe, guys, for this content. Look at that beauty. Ooh, boy. So apparently this aircraft didn't go well for them. Who knows what happened exactly. I got some accidents in here and there, and there weren't that many produced either. I'm hoping we can turn because it is windy. Alright, so what we'll do again, since the wind is really blowing us around here, we're gonna turn off everything off. We're gonna get our tugboat back on here because apparently this wind is just really pushing us. So we're gonna try to head out a little bit like northeast, north northeast, or east northeast, not too sure which one it is, but either way. Out these around this area, we're gonna just shoot out and then turn right back on our route. So I guess there's a way to bring these up when you're in flight, from what I heard, and we're gonna try to see if we can figure out how to do that. But I think this is a beauty, isn't it, guys? And no head tracker for today, guys. I think sometimes head tracker is just good for, or it just makes it easier and nice, you know, so you don't have to move them out so much. But I think literally it's the same thing, man. I don't really see no difference. All right. A little bit more out, and then we'll take off. Here we go. Let's see now. What happens is that once we start, oh, look at those flames. Believe that, guys, 1942. That's insane, bro. All right. Now here we go. So we're gonna start taking off. You get the flaps down. Move this out of the way. Alrighty, guys. Let's get for takeoff. Throttle. Hitting that rudder. Not too sure why we aren't able to. There we go. Just a bit. Jeez Louise. A little dangerous. Try to fix that. Lift up. That was a little scary. Wow. It is windy though. Alright, so we'll loop. We'll cross left. Make a little loop. Alright, let me get back inside. If not, we're gonna... Gotta watch our speeds as well. Bring our flaps up. So I don't think we're gonna need it. So the buoy things, is it this? Let's see. Alright, it is. Look at that. Wow, look how much cleaner that looks too. Oh, dude, it's humongous. That's what she said, right? Alright. Well, thanks to Microsoft Flight Simulator for this incredible sim. And Blue Mesh for the Latécoère 631. Imagine seeing this thing back in the sky. Or a replica. Never know. I forgot I was going to show you the interior and all that good stuff while we're flying. Obviously no autopilot here, but it is very detailed back there. I'll show you maybe once we land. That's not good. It's getting a little oh yeah, we're going into the clouds, okay. So there is a bunch of videos of the interior and all that good stuff, which I think looks amazing. Those mountains. So I do want to know how accurate is the inside of the aircraft to the original. Like if everything I'm seeing here is the exact, you know, how it looked. Going over Neapolis, Agios, Nikolaos, Crete. We'll start descending shortly. get some more outside views, because that's the whole point, right? So there are no gears on this aircraft. We are going to be pulling out our bayonets real soon. I know I probably said that wrong, but weather was insane. Latécoère, so we'll start releasing our buoys, or whatever you call those floaties. Airport, Satia, that's what they call it. Alright, let's take out our handy dandy notebook and let's do auto shutdown. I'll take your rounds. While that's happening. So like I said, you guys can do the checklist if you want. It's pretty good. You're not gonna have any issues with that, but let's go ahead and get to the back here. So obviously this is, like I said, highly detailed. Check it out in the marketplace. Job well done. And I know I can tell you this, guys, that I'm not a fan of, you know, just any random plane. But this one was actually interesting, you know, to fly, and something different, something you don't usually see, right? Or you're never gonna see. But yeah, look at that. Look at the time and effort that he put into this one. Look at that. Alright. Give the guy some effort. Definitely deserves it. I think there is more, but I'm obviously there's other videos showing off the bottom part and all that good stuff. But either way, if you had a lot of fun like I did, guys, hit the like button, guys, subscribe. And I think that's it right now. So hopefully you guys enjoyed that one, 'cause I know I did. If you want to see more content like this, make make sure you join the membership, guys. $1.99 for the membership. If you want to join, exclusive videos for you guys. If you guys join that, you'll see what I'm working on, and you'll see certain videos that I won't post on public. And yeah, let me know, guys. Have a good one. Peace.